short videos just to show those clients that want to have some monitoring of the reject conveyor motor enabled on their check wire. A typical check wire from A&D, our popular model from Japan, basically consists of two conveyors. There's an in-feed conveyor here and then a weighing conveyor here. Now our reject module would come straight after the check wire, and obviously in this case there's no reject module on our demonstration machine. And the way the check wire is set up electronically, if there's someone overloading or there's a jam on one of those conveyors that's overloading the motor, electronically it sends a signal back to the display and it causes the system to stop and gives an alarm or a prompt to the operator so they can remove the cause of the overload and then proceed with production. Now in the case of having a reject module added, out of the box, as I just explained, this system doesn't have a rejector. So when we attach a rejector to the check wire, we need to tell the check wire that there's a rejector there so it can also monitor the status of the motor on the rejector. And what I'll do now is just quickly show you how that's done. So firstly, you've got to log in to the system. If you haven't changed it, the default login is admin with a capital A. Gotta love the old Nokia style keyboard. And the password is a very imaginative 4 zeros. So once you're logged in, it'll change up here from being operator to admin. And you can see that happen now. So it says admin. Now that gives us the ability to change certain settings. And when we go into the main settings, this is the global settings on the check wire. You wouldn't normally be able to access those as an operator. You can see there's three tabs at the top. The first one, balance, is to do with the weight configuration, and what we want is system one, which is the one highlighted at the moment. In here, the top right, there's a tab which says external device. And at the moment, reject monitoring is disabled. So if we touch that and then choose this setting, basically that's the model number of all of our reject modules of varying sorts, and we hit okay. Now what will happen when we start the check wire, and of course there's no rejector connected to this one, so it's going to think there's an error straight away. As soon as you press start, it goes stop, there's a problem with the rejector. So the conveyor's got a drama and the motor signal has come back to the check wire saying there's a problem, please fix it. So that's how you enable the reject monitoring, and if you've got an A&D rejector with your check wire, we highly recommend that you enable that feature so that your rejector, if there is a build-up of product or it gets overloaded, doesn't wear out without warning people. Thanks very much for watching.